Beloved in Christ, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Today is the seventh Sunday of Easter, and Only God series comes your way with the Word of God that which nourishes our spiritual journey. Today also happens to be Mother's Day, where we celebrate all our mothers for the good work they have done in our lives, for nurturing and for guiding. So we want to wish all our mothers a happy Mother's Day. May God continually bless you and sustain you. Today I would like to reflect with you on the theme, You Are Not of This World. You are not of this world. Beloved in Christ, this theme is being inspired by the gospel reading of today, where we encounter the priestly prayer of Jesus in the Gospel of John, where Jesus prays for his disciples and asks that even though they are in the world, they should not be of the world. Even though they are living in the world, they should not be of this world. What Jesus was praying for is very necessary for all Christians, because in our day-to-day activities, we find ourselves in this world. A world in our day which is filled full of evil, full of challenges, full of trials, full of a lot of vices. The Christian finding himself in this world, we are supposed to be witnesses to God even in these vices. That is why Jesus would pray for you, he would pray for me, and he's praying for his apostles because we need it. We need this prayer of our Lord because we cannot be in the world and not be of it, and this is not something easy to do. Beloved in Christ, in the face of these challenges, in the face of these vices, in the face of these broken promises, God encourages us that we should not be of this world. How then do we be in the world yet not be of the world? We are proposing two things that we can look at. That our lives will be a life of witnessing to the gospel. That we will be people of love. That we will be people who somebody can look at our lives as Christians and say, because of this man, because of this woman, because of this priest, because of this Christian, I will also become a Christian. I will also become a Catholic. In this way, we would use our lives to draw others to the kingdom of God. So the first thing for us to be in the world but not of the world is to become witnesses who our lives will draw others to the kingdom of God. Our lives would encourage others to also be part of the Christian fold. How then would our life be able to draw others? By loving one another, by showing kindness, by showing love, by building up the virtues of harmony and peace among one another. And secondly, after being witnesses, we should also do our best to be prayerful. Because even Jesus prayed. If we are not prayerful, without prayer, we cannot be good witnesses to the gospel. Without prayer, we cannot stay away from the vices of this world. Without prayer, we cannot be people who will be able to draw others by our lives. So by witnessing and coupling it with prayer, we will be able to live the authentic Christian life, so that it will always be a reminder to us that we are not of this world, but we are for God. This is because you and I were created in the image and likeness of God. So we cannot be people of this world, but we have to live our lives like people who have had an encounter with the Holy Spirit. So as we prepare ourselves in this novena towards Pentecost, the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, let us be prayerful and let us set out to be witnesses to the gospel. As we do this, when the Holy Spirit comes on the day of Pentecost, we would also be encouraged and be consecrated to be able to live lives worthy of the Christian life. Remember, you are not of this world. Let your life stand out and be an example to others. Throughout this week, may the Lord continually favor you. May He continually bless and sustain you and help you with His grace to be able to draw others to you by your lifestyle. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Have a blessed week.